Welcome back everyone, it's Lodestar here, and this is my Kingdom Hearts HD Dream Drop Distance playthrough. And yeah, this is part 31, and today we're going to be starting the new world here, Symphony of Sorcery, with Sora. So yeah, this is actually going to be our last Disney world that we're going to be doing, so yeah. That's kind of sad, but you know, we almost finished this game, which is good, I suppose, because no, I'm just going to take those two things, because Kingdom Hearts 3 is in about, I would say about a week or two now, we'll be exactly a month away from it, so yeah, it's getting there. Now let me very quickly have a look at my stuff. I'll put All For One on, even though it is actually weaker in strength. What will I have here? Oh, I think I know. I keep forgetting the quickest way to do this is move the one that hasn't got anything on. I think I may have Shadowbreaker on for now. We're going to get a real good thing, move in this world soonish. I put Sonic Impact back on. So yeah, there we go. This world is also quite a bit difficult, I'm not going to lie. I'm probably going to die a few times. Because if you guys didn't know, I do kind of do like this sort of practice run thing. And yeah, it's a bit difficult. Yeah, I suppose, I feel like with this game, it definitely gets a lot harder towards the end on critical. For the most part, I didn't have any problems with this game on Proud. Like, I usually manage to beat everything pretty easily, but you know, critical is definitely difficult. But we're going to be doing the dive now. This dive, from what I remember, isn't too difficult. I did get A rank on my first time light test recording this, so okay, I say that and then get hit. But yeah, now we need to get 900 points. Well, yeah, that happened. I actually died this time. This is the first time of me actually dying in a dive. Yeah. That wasn't very pleasant. I'm gonna have to start over. Okay, you can hit the small ones. I thought you could go for just the white ones. My bad. I failed to note that in the last part. But my test recording anyway. And yeah, this world that we're actually going to is one of my more favourite Disney worlds in this game, to be honest. I think I like the Country of the Musketeers a bit more. That's probably my favourite Disney world in this game. The Hunchback in Notre Dame is also a good one. But I just don't like its boss very much. With Sora anyway, with Rico it's not too bad. I may get A rank now. Maybe it's a good thing that I died. There we go, that was nice. Alright, I'm not going to bother now, risking all that. There we go! Hopefully that's enough to get A. And there we go, it was great. Fleeting Fantasy, it must be very rare. I didn't read the description, but I could just imagine that it would be one of the rare ones. Oh yes, in this world we will be able to get the T-Rex as well at some time, the stage. Which is good because it has once more, and that's what I really need. So obviously this movie, or this world, is taking inspiration from the Fantasia movie. Which again, I haven't seen most of these movies that are in this game. It just clicked to me. I have not seen Pinocchio. I did when I was little, but I don't remember barely anything from it. So I'm actually going to put that as I haven't seen. I haven't seen any Tron, even the original.
Am I back at Master Yen Sid's tower?
Didn't see this one or the Country of the Musketeers. I did see Hunchback of Notre Dame.
Something seems off.
And that's about it for the Disney Worlds. So yeah, that's kind of sad.
King Mickey!
Oh, he's possessed by darkness. Seeing that darkness like spray off him like that, it reminds me of Terror.
Is this what's troubling him? Alright.
You tried.
Gosh, is that a keyblade? Who are you an apprentice to? I'm Mickey, the sorcerer's apprentice.
Oh, apprentice? Wait, am I in some world where the king was still in training? So, does that mean this world is sleeping?
What's wrong?
What? Oh, I'm Sora, the, apprentice of, hey, listen, your magic.
It doesn't matter.
I gotta stop that.
I like that bit.
What can I do to save you?
Thank you, Sora.
And you see that, says, stop
it's
that.
It's no use. A monster's possessed that music, and he's releasing darkness that stops anybody from going in there to fight him. To dispel the darkness, we need a sound idea.
It's that Dream Eater I let escape. Okay, where do I get a sound idea?
What? You'll find one for me?
Of course!
Thank you!
It's not every day I get to do a favor for the king.
Huh? Did you say something?
Oh, nothing. Long story. So what exactly is a sound idea?
Inside this musical score should be a power that can sweep away any darkness. But you gotta be careful. In between those clefts and notes are monsters. Not as strong as the big one, but still pretty strong.
Got it.
Well, there you go. That's what we gotta do. Bam. Again, one of my more favorite Disney worlds in this game. Okay, we got the reality shift. Melody Catcher. Press the buttons on the glowing line and hold the button on the green line to conduct along with the rhythm. In some areas, Melody Catcher will change the environment and open new routes. Okay, so I guess we'll view the flashback. Well, you don't mess with things you don't understand, that's all I'm gonna say. So, we are supposed to go through here to progress through the story, but first, we are going to exit out and go to the outside area, because there are a few chests. Like that one. Well, I'm gonna change that to that Dream Eater there. Okay, we got a few enemies outside. And again, like I said, owl, at the start, as you can see, this is where the game gets a little bit more difficult. Oh yeah, my heels are back. Well, that don't matter, I suppose. Alright, we're back. I just took out maybe a little bit of them, not all of them, obviously. Now, every time you hit them, it makes a sort of musical, oh dear, note kind of sound. And I'm not going to lie, this is one of my least favourite things about this world, because it gets so annoying. But yeah, there's a chest. And here's another one. Ah, dang, I was hoping that there wouldn't be any Dream Eaters out here. There's not much point in me fighting them. So yeah, that is all the treasures outside. Okay, this is the reality shift. Pretty easy. They do get a little bit more complicated, but not by much. Not the worst reality shift. I prefer it over some. Like the Pinocchio one and Tron one. I think my favourite one would have to be Faithline from the Hunchback of Notre Dame though. I just thought that was quite a neat one. And just fun to use. But yeah, let's jump into the musical rhythm. Or realm, sorry. All those flower petals remind me of Marluxia. Alright, so it's going to be a bit difficult from this point on. I'm probably going to die quite a bit and there'll be a lot of cuts. Again, I'll try and do my best to survive, but again, this world definitely takes it up to another level. And yeah, I'm going to be spamming the, what's it called again? Shock dive quite a bit. I haven't done this in quite a while, like spam it this hard. But to be quite honest, this world does get quite difficult. I press triangle. Oh, he's dead anyway. Oh wow, it's really loud in my headset. I'm gonna turn that down a bit. It's a boom boom boom. It was so loud. And yeah, that's all shoot. That's what I was talking about before in one of the last few parts of Shadowbreaker. Is that one with that dark attack and then it goes to a light attack. It's really odd seeing Sora use like a dark attack. Alright, well, here's another cut. Alright, I am back. These penguins are very powerful in this world. Like, crazy. Which is good. I mean, I like penguins and everything. Okay, getting rid of you. There we go, man. They just fly around everywhere. Oh, now we have the fish things, still. I hate the fish in this game. Mainly due to their blind attack that they do. And this, when you can't hit them for some reason. Alright, we're almost leveled up, which is okay. As well as I'm gonna probably have to level grind at least two levels before fighting the boss in this world. Cause man, I don't know, critical's just hard for me. At least in this game. Alright, so to progress you have to actually use your reality shift on this thing. And yes, rainbows will appear and you get to ride the rainbow. There we go. Okay, here is a chest. And we obtained glide. While controlling Sora, press circle and hold circle while jumping to fly through the air. Once you obtain super glide, you'll be able to fly even faster speeds. I think there is only one way to get a super glide, and that is obtaining a specific Dream Eater and doing it through their ability link board thing. And he is introduced in this world. We fought him once. He was that dragon looking one. I would have to probably show on a picture or something, but I don't think I have any oops, I went into the wrong thing. Anything to really show. I can unlock that. There we go. Still need another 95 points. There's not much point in me actually going through all this at the moment. But yeah, we've almost got our last treasure magnet. And for you, sure we'll get Thunder Boost. There we go. Is there anything else in this bit? I don't think so. Any chests, I mean. I think the next few are down this way. And I could die here, and if I do, that's going to be extremely annoying. No enemies will spawn when you're walking here. But when you go for this chest, they spawn down here, so... yeah. It's a bit interesting. Oh. At least they didn't stun me when they hit me. Okay, owl, penguin, can you not? Again, I want to create one of the penguins. I don't think it's these ones. It's one that we haven't come across, I don't think. It's the one wearing jandals. Like, if you see with... oh, these are the dragon ones I was talking about earlier. Ah! They send fire X's at you. But, oh dear. They are extremely powerful too. You know what? I'm gonna use my, thing. I don't remember what it's called. Okay, I don't know if that did really anything, but okay. Okay, no, I did do some damage to them. Okay, there we go. There's one, and we gotta level up. Oh. Oh dear. Freak. That was close. See, when Sora uses the darkness, it looks so out of character for him. But oh well. Now, I think it was... ah, dang, there's more enemies. But don't they spawn on me? Okay, he's not spawning anymore. Anyway, this chest, I think, is the one that you get the epic... no, never mind, it's not. Maybe it's this one? Okay, never mind. There is a chest in this world where you get the important ingredient to be able to create the T-Rex that gives you once more. Which is, you know, the one I'm looking for. Maybe it's this one. Maybe it's that one? I'm pretty sure it was Epic, though. Epic! Yeah, that reminds me of the Fortnite developer name. Where are those nightmares gone? There were enemies that are supposed to spawn here. They just did. Oh well. Anyway, I'm gonna go down through here. There's a chest. As well as some, these guys. Haven't put these guys in a while. Kind of fits that they're on the cliff, though. Man, these enemies are just despawning. What is up with this? I don't know if this is normal. They don't spawn back either. I don't think they do. Oh no, they do some stuff. Oh dang, I didn't see what I got from that chest. I don't know if that was the epic thing I was looking for. Dang, that dragon has despawned. Bam. Yeah, get stunned. Oh dear. Okay, there we go. Whew, that was scary. Alright, you see this thing here? We're gonna use our reality shift on it. There we go. So what will that do? That will, okay. It'll give us more areas, or one more clouds to move on. Oh, wrong way. This way. Okay. So, there's a big chest up there. There is a chest here. An elixir. I think that's our first elixir in this game. Though, they're not really that great as what they were in, like, Kingdom Hearts 1 or 2. What are you? This is what I was wanting. A prism windmill. Now, it's just like fire windmill, but just a lot better, in my opinion. Does a lot of damage. Ooh, I might take it out for a shadow breaker. There it is. So, we'll be able to see me using that in the next part. Because guess what? This is where this part comes to an end. Thank you for watching, everyone. This was Lodestar playing Kingdom Hearts HD Dream Drop Distance. This was part 31, and in part 32, we'll be continuing Symphony of Sorcery. So yeah, feel free to leave a like and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next part. Bye.